Hey everyone, welcome to our channel. If you don't know who we are, we're Lighting Trendz. We sell aftermarket LED lighting to give your vehicle the best look to stand out above the rest. Today, we're taking this Tesla Model S Plaid to the next level with an interior dash trim kit. This installation takes on average about 8 hours depending on your skill level, and we consider it an intermediate to advanced install. Please keep in mind, every vehicle is different due to the design, but we'll be showing you universal installation for most vehicles. These aren't just any interior dash trim strip. They're flexible, they're bright, they can be cut to size, and they look clean even when they're off. When you purchase the Lighting Trendz Flow Series dash trim kit, what's going to be included are two 43-inch strips, a voltage regulator, controller of your choice if you select it, whether it's the Blue Ghost controller, or standard Flow Series Bluetooth, or a handheld remote. In addition to that, depending on the controller you select, you'll also receive a 4 output harness. And if you add additional strips, which is an option, we will give the correct number of splitters so that you have enough outputs on your device. As far as customizing these strips, getting them to fit your vehicle, they can be cut to size every LED. You could actually feel on the black tape here, it has raised spots and dips. You would cut in between two of the raised spots. The raised spots are going to be the LED itself, and you're good to go. When installing these lights, there's a couple different options. For certain panels, you have the ability to actually just slide it in the gap, push it all the way in until it kind of bottoms out, and you're good to go. Other ones where they have more aggressive bends or it needs to go almost forward or backwards, you're better off actually removing the panel that you want to mount this to and doing a little bit of hot glue at any point where you feel it may lift. This will help keep it in place for the life of the kit. So getting started on the actual installation of the strips. When you're working on the dashboard, sometimes you don't need to actually remove any panels. You're good to either just slide the strip in, or if you use a plastic trim tool like this, you can open the gap a little bit, slide it in, get it started. Other times, you may have to remove different pieces. If that's the case, tools you're gonna need, screwdrivers, plastic trim tools, and in certain cases, you may want a clip puller of sorts. When you actually start to mount the strip, what you're gonna wanna do is begin on the side with the wire. Normally, what I try to do is actually get the connector and everything past the point, have that tucked away, and then start right around here. That way, when you hit the end, you know exactly where you need to trim. You could also cut it beforehand, start on this side if that's easier for you. There's no right or wrong way of doing it. Either way, it's pretty straightforward and easy to install. Next, we're gonna talk about getting the door panels off the vehicle and getting started with that. So for that, again, gonna depend on the vehicle. Some are a little bit more straightforward than others, but for the most part, you're looking at one or two screws and a bunch of clips going all the way around. We advise looking online, seeing what kind of information's out there and looking into it prior to trying to remove the door panels. So once you have all the screws removed, the way I personally like to start it is go from the bottom, try to find the nearest clip, get one of these guys in there, pop the first few clips to get it started, and then from there, you can actually grab on the door panel from a cup holder or something like that and get the rest of the clips off and out of the way. More often than not, most vehicles, you then have to slide the panel up and off of a little lip. Once you have everything removed and the door panel is free, the last thing you want to do is look for a cable. A lot of times you'll see there's an actual cable that's connected to the handle. In addition to that, there's almost always going to be a harness for the window switch, lock, unlock, that kind of stuff. Just make sure there's no wires or anything connected when you go to remove that. You don't want to cause any damage. So once you get your actual door panel off of the vehicle, what you're gonna wanna do, set it somewhere nice and safe. And from there, try to find the best spot to mount the strip. You'll see a lot of times once the panel's actually off, it's got a little bit more flex to it. You can actually increase the gap a little bit, or again, these guys won't let you down. And you can start sliding the strip in. Again, I always start from the wire end first. If needed, you can de-pin these 3-pin JSD connectors. Now you can peel back the heat shrink a little bit, and I personally like to use tweezers or a pick, push the pin down, pull it right off, and that'll allow it to fit through tighter spaces. You're gonna want to look for any kind of gap that will allow the wire to pass through, give a clean look, not be visible, but still be safe and not pinched in any way. Once you got that all done, you're good to slide the strip in the rest of the way, cut it just like we talked about in the beginning of the video, and you're good to go. From there, we advise letting the strip test prior to putting it back in the vehicle. So the last thing you want to do is put your car back together and realize damage was caused in the process of installation. Now to do it, 1 to 3 more times depending on your vehicle. All right, so once you get to this point where you're ready to actually run the extension through the harness and the door, you're gonna wanna follow the OEM wiring harness, go through that grommet. The easiest way to do that is gonna be to, again, depin the JST extension. It'll make it a little bit more slim, allow it to fit through tighter spaces, and it won't fight you quite as much. What we like to do here is we'll take a big zip tie, whether it's something 12 inches, even bigger. You can use electrical tape, wrap the extension to that zip tie, and it's something a little bit more solid where you could poke it through the grommet, pull it all the way through, and then as you pull the zip tie, the extension will go with it. If you try to just feed the wire through, you're not gonna have the best time. It's a little flimsy, it's gonna wanna bend, not gonna go nicely.
Once you're done routing all the wires, you're good to take the OEM grommet, pop it back into place, and make sure it's fully seated to avoid getting any water inside the vehicle or door. For this particular install, we had multiple strips in each door. We always recommend running separate extensions for each strip to avoid any voltage loss. This time, we created one thicker extension using 18 gauge wiring. It ended up being easier than running two of the 22 gauge extensions included with the kit, but it was also thick enough to avoid any resistance related issues. From there, we soldered on two ends so that we had two outputs, one for each strip.
Last thing you gotta do before you get the door panel back on your car is take the metal end of your extension, plug that in to the strip, and you're good to go. Make sure the wires aren't dangling, make sure it's not in the way of any clips. As long as there's no wires or anything in the way, you're good to start by lifting the door panel. You wanna get it caught up top, roll it down, and once it's all lined up, you give it a good smack and kind of go around and make sure all the clips are seated. All right, so now you got all your extensions ran, vehicle put back together. Last thing you gotta do is hook up all the wiring to the vehicle itself. You're gonna wanna take your voltage regulator and you'll see there is a power and negative ring terminal on it. You have a few choices on how you could wire this up to the vehicle. First would be connect these straight to the batteries, positive and negative. Next would be ground the black one, hook the positive up to a switch, or you could wire it to ignition so that your lights come on anytime you start the vehicle. Once this guy's wired into the vehicle, all you gotta do is connect your flow series controller of choice to the 2-pin connector. Connect all your extension wires or strips straight to the 4 output harness or the controller itself, and you're good to go. Stay tuned. In the future, we will have a video on how to fully wire and install your flow series LED controllers. If you have any questions on this product, don't hesitate to stop by the shop, give us a call, or shoot us an email. More than happy to help you out. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Click the bell for notifications. Thank you for watching. We'll see you in the next video. Does it right now look like I'm looking at the camera, or does it look like I'm staring in the space?
No, you look like you're staring at the space, damn it.
You're gonna want to slide it through. No, I gotta restart because I just started closing my eyes. No, I don't like that. I hate it.
I liked it.
Okay. Anything? No.
No, that was good. I think it was fine. I'm gonna cut out the end.
You're gonna cut out the crying.